Hello everyone, this is Dr. Shivakant Pathak, here available with you to take one important topic of kinetic theory of gas, that is specific heat capacity for monoatomic, diatomic and triatomic gases. So first of all we are going to calculate for monoatomic gas. Monoatomic gas, here is an example: helium, neon, argon, these are monatomic gases belonging to the zero group in periodic table. We are knowing that in a molecule, monatomic gases, there are 3 degrees of freedom. 3 degrees of freedom, and each degree of freedom has degree of freedom has half kT kinetic energy per molecule per degree of freedom. So we may write average kinetic energy per molecule with 3 degrees of freedom is equal to 3 into 1/2 kT is equal to 3/2 kT. This is represented by equation number 1. Now we are going to see average energy per 1 gram mole. If you are going to for or with 3 degrees of freedom, if you are going to calculate, this energy is represented by U. See very carefully, 1 gram mole means in 1 gram mole there are capital N. Capital N is Avogadro number, capital N number of atom available according to the mole concept. So energy in that condition becomes Avogadro number into the total energy belonging to the 3 degrees of freedom, that is 3/2 kT. Then it's become 3/2 nkT, where N we are knowing, N is equal to Avogadro number, right? Now see here, in this case N into K, K is a Boltzmann constant, N into K here in this case is called universal gas constant, capital R. Capital R is universal gas constant. Then this average energy per gram mole with 3 degree of freedom, U is given by formula 3/2 RT. See, and this is represented by equation number 2. If see here, du denotes the small amount of heat. This is du denotes a small amount of heat required to increase dT temperature of 1 gram mole of gas at constant volume. So amount of heat is obtained by formula mc delta t. So according to this question, the amount of required is du, mass is 1 gram mole, c is specific heat capacity at condition constant volume, so it is denoted by cv into rise in temperature delta t. This gives du is equal to cv dt, and it is represented by equation number 3. Now see here in this formula, this is equation number 3. We may write equation 3 speaks du by dt is equal to cv. Cv is specific heat capacity of 1 gram mole of gas at constant volume. It is, now see Cv, we may obtain Cv is equal to d by dt of u. For u we may refer equation 2. This is 3 by 2 rt. By equation 3 in a bracket using equation 2. So differentiation, it is dt by dt is 1, 3 by 2 r. So specific heat capacity at constant volume is 3 by 2 r. We may write it is equation number 4th here. And this universal gas constant is 1.985 calorie per mole per Kelvin. Then Cv can be written as 3 by 2 R is equal to 3 by 2 into 1.985 is equal to, after solving we may get 3.98 calorie per mole per Kelvin. This is Cv. So this value is specific heat capacity of monoatomic gas like helium, neon, etc. at constant volume. We are knowing the Mayer's formula also, that is Cp minus Cv is equal to R. Or by this equation we may write Cp is equal to R plus Cv. Value of R is here given, universal gas constant 1.985 plus Cv for monatomic gas, just we have calculated, it is 2.98. After adding both we may obtain it is 4.96 calorie per mole per Kelvin. So specific heat capacity of monoatomic gas is given by 4.98 calorie per mole per Kelvin, whereas specific heat capacity at constant volume is 2.98. This is, now we may write, calculate gamma. Gamma is equal to ratio of Cp to Cv for monatomic gas. We are going Cp, we just obtained 4.96 and it is 2.98, and after calculating we may obtain this dividing 1.67. it is pure ratio, so it has no unit. So ratio of specific heat capacity to specific heat capacity at constant pressure to specific heat capacity at constant volume is given by this formula. Now we are going to see specific heat capacity for diatomic gas. diatomic case if we are going to take, in that we will take example O2, H2, in such like this gases, oxygen, hydrogen, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, like this. The gases, some gases are in vapor form also. So for that we are going to, for diatomic gas we are knowing there are two type of vibration in the energy. This total energy is due to translational motion plus due to total energy rotational motion. It is a sum of both. We are knowing this formula. In translational motion we are knowing 3 degree of freedom, whereas in this there are 2 degree of freedom. So its total make here in this case diatomic, 3 plus 2 means total 5 degree of freedom. And we know that since each degree of freedom has energy half kT, where K is Boltzmann constant, so we may write total energy per molecule with 5 degrees of freedom. This is equal to 5 into 1 by 2 kT. This is 5 by 2 kT can be represented here in this next equation, here in this case. Now see, we are going to calculate total energy of 1 gram mole with 5 degrees of freedom. So let it is U is equal to, here in diatomic gas 5 degree of freedom, and each degree of freedom has energy, average energy half kT, right, into 1 gram mole. This is, so this becomes 5 by 2 kN into T. Since we know that KN is equal to universal gas constant R, so it's become 5 by 2 RT, and it is represented by another equation. Now the same process we are continuing as we have applied in case of monoatomic gases. If we take DU, amount of energy of diatomic gas of 1 gram mole, DU denotes the amount of energy of diatomic gases of 1 gram mole, GMOLE, 1 gram mole, to increase the temperature dT at constant volume, then DU can be written as, by using formula C here in the box, Q is equal to MC delta T. By using this formula Q we have taken DU, mass we have taken 1 gram mole, this situation is as constant volume, so it is Cv into rise in temperature is a dT. This implies that Cv is equal to du by dT. By using previous equation d by dt, here in case of diatomic gas, this u is given 5 by 2 rt. So here in this equation, by this 5 by 2 r is a constant. So dt by dt is 1, differential of t with respect to t is 1. So Cv becomes 5 by 2 r. 5 by 2 r is 1.985 calorie per mole per Kelvin. So by calculating, we may write specific heat capacity at constant volume is 4.96 calorie per mole per Kelvin Cv. Per Kelvin, this is for a diatomic. Now we are going to calculate Cp for a diatomic molecule. So for that we are going to use Mayer's formula. So Mayer's formula speaks Cp minus Cv is equal to R. So this implies that Cp is equal to Cv plus R. Cv we have just calculated 4.96, and Re we know universal gas constant is 1.985. By adding both we may obtain this value is 6.95 calorie per mole per Kelvin. It is Cp. So specific heat capacity at constant pressure for diatomic molecule is 6.95 and for constant volume it is 4.96. Then ratio, we are going to see gamma for diatomic molecule. So this is Cp by Cv. It is Cp is 6.95 just we have calculated. By 4.96 the ratio of both is come 1.4 approx. So gamma, that is the ratio between Cp by Cv is 1.4. So it is a dimensionless quantity, pure ratio, so it has a no unit. Now we are going to see specific heat capacity for triatomic molecule. So far see triatomic molecule, the total energy is due to all three: translational energy plus rotational energy plus vibrational energy. Right, for translational energy there are 3 degree of freedom, for rotational energy there are 2 degree of freedom, and for vibrational energy there are also 2 degrees of freedom. We have seen this in previous lectures also. So total degree of freedom is equal to 3 plus 2 plus 2 is equal to 7. 7 in number. 7 degree of freedom is here. So total energy per molecule with 7 degree of freedom is equal to total energy. This is equal to, we may write 7, and each degree of freedom we know half kT. this total become 7/2 kt. Now see this, this is for 7/2 kt, in case of triatomic molecule we have total energy per molecule with 7 degrees of freedom. And if we are calculate the U, U denotes the total energy 1 gram of mole, which is equal to, we may write 7/2 RT we may write. Similarly, without wasting of time, because it is only to repeat the calculation, so no need. We understand because the same process we have done in monatomic complete process and diatomic 7/2. And so by using this relation, du is equal to 1 here mc delta t, this is at constant volume cv, into dt, or this implies that cv is equal to du by dt, and du by dt, so d by dt of u is 7/2 RT, right? So this becomes CV is equal to 7/2 R, right? 7/2 R is, by writing the value 7/2 R is 1.985. After calculating 7.2, this is 6.95 calorie per mole per Kelvin. This is value of a CP here in this case. Now see, since we know that the Mayer's formula, CP minus CV is equal to R, by this relation we may obtain CP is equal to CV plus R. CV is given 6.95 plus R is 1.985. this total makes, when we add both, it becomes 8.9 calorie per mole per Kelvin. This is CP here in triatomic molecule. And gamma, this is CP by CV is equal to 8.9 by 6.95. after reducing it, it is 21.28 we obtain. In case of triatomic molecule, we obtain this calculation only and only if triatomic molecule is example of linear molecule, right? If it is non-linear molecule, then in place of 7 degree of freedom, it has only 6 degree of freedom. So in triatomic molecule, we can divide it by 2. In that case, special case 1, when triatomic molecule is in form of linear structure, let us example I am taking, it is carbon dioxide, carbon, oxygen, oxygen, linear structure. Then calculation is for that. If it is non-linear like water molecule, then the calculation will be different because there are only 6 degree of freedom available. For non-linear triatomic molecule has 6 degree of freedom. If we choose example water molecule, hydrogen is a central atom, oxygen is a central atom, and hydrogen is 2 hydrogen. It is a non-linear structure. In this non-linear structure, there are only 6 degree of freedom. Then total energy of 1 gram mole of this type of non-linear structure of gases, actually it is not, water vapor can also exist in form of gas, right? Water gas, right? Then U can be becomes equal to 6 into 1/2 kT RT, so it is 3 RT, right? And we are knowing that CV, we have seen du by dt, So it is d by dt of 3RT is equal to, by differentiating we may say 3R only. So CV is equal to 3, R is 1.985, it total makes 5.96 calorie per mole per Kelvin. And Cp is equal to, by using Mayer formula, Cv plus R, this is 5.96 plus 1.985 is equal to 7.94 calorie per gram. And Poisson ratio gamma is equal to Cp by Cv, it is equal to 5.96 by 7.94, it is equal to 1.33, the Poisson gamma we can obtain when this structure is non-linear. Now we are going to see for the fourth. We have calculated for monoatomic, diatomic and polyatomic, triatomic. Now we are going to see for polyatomic gas. Now we are going to see for polyatomic gases. So see for polyatomic gases, the how degree of freedom divided. See in the first branch, 3 translational degrees of freedom due to translational motion, 3 rotational degree of freedom due to rotational motion of molecule, and certain number of vibration degree of freedom, it depends on the structure of a molecule, polyatomic molecule, how this arranged, right? So if you want to calculate U, what is U? Total internal energy of 1 gram of mole with all degrees of freedom. So 3 by 2 kT for translational, 3 by 2 kT for rotational, and F number for, certain F number for kT. So 3 by 2 kT plus 3 by 2 kT into F kT for 1 mole multiplied by Avogadro number. So by calculating this, U can be obtained. So here in this case, Cv, specific heat capacity at constant volume, by calculating this, we may write it is 3 plus F into R, Cv, and Cp we may obtain, Cp is equal to Cv plus R, Cv is 3 plus F R plus R. So what does it become? 4 plus F into R, this is Cp, and gamma for polyatomic gases, it is Cp by Cv, can be obtained by formula 4 plus F into R by 3 plus F. This is equal to 4 plus F by 3 plus F. So this is for polyatomic gases. So thank you everybody.